Okay, that was weird. My recording just stopped. I don't even know what that happened. Oh.
Lend me your ears, everyone. Or perhaps one of you might like to start us off. How about you, friend?
Oh dear, don't ask him.
No, I don't think I can.
You cannot do this.
Then, how about you, good sir?
Who? Oh, holy shit.
I fear that I will cause the mood on this boat to become as somber as it is in court.
Well then, I guess we're lucky we've got a local like me to organize things. Wonderful, the spotlight at last. I guess I'll be facilitating things from here.
That was a little long-winded, don't you think?
Oh, you might be right. Anyway, to cut to the chase, our friend here, the Traveler, has brought us together to discuss something.
Yeah, kinda need your guys' help.
As for what that is, well, let's start by saying that we'll be pooling our efforts together to create a series of traps.
Yeah, this is gonna be fun. Just hold on something. I need to confirm something. Okay, and I return. Alright, so I return and I think I figured out why the video stopped. It's because I reached 2 hours.
Huh. How intriguing.
Well, it's just an expression, really. One that I just learned from Clorand. And use on the spot. So, let's invite her to explain in detail. A round of applause, please.
Yay. This is awkward.
Huh? Didn't you say that you would be facilitating this?
Oh, come now. Your work doesn't involve much public speaking, right? This is a good chance to practice. You might even pick up some fancy oratory tricks to impress your boss with in the future.
Oh my.
I see. And what does my boss say?
He is glad that you consider him your boss. Do go on.
Huh. All right.
In that case, do any of you have experience hunting? Not that I recall.
I do.
Fremenae and I once used a wooden stick in a basket to catch wild rabbits when we were younger. As for Lynette, right. You were sick that day, weren't you?
I've also gone diving to catch some fish before. Does that count?
I guess it does.
I'm afraid not.
Oh.
You may or may not have heard, but Fontaine once played host to a group known as the Marechaussee Hunters. Though that was their name, they did not hunt animals, but rather various monsters left behind by the ancient dynasty of King Remus. Today, Fontaine's monster population has already thinned greatly, so the hunters have blended back into society, taking up arms in other lines of work. They even left a unique methodology of hunting in their wake. A trap comprises of the following components: bait, a trigger, and a containment device. Sometimes a lethal implement will also be necessary to deal with the prey. So, if we were to build a trap together, right now, what would you choose to build it with?
For me, I would prefer something basket-shaped. Pigeons and rabbits will see the bait and naturally enter the snare. Our line of work requires a deft hand, and we're some of the best in the industry, so you can count on our techniques.
You used some of those techniques while moving the people of Poisson, didn't you? My subordinates mentioned that you even performed some magic for the bawling children.
Aww. Yes, and I even managed to gather some intelligence in the meantime. I'm quite the multitasker, if I do say so myself.
I'm afraid I can't claim that as my strong suit. I prefer more stable methods, like placing bait in the water and waiting for the fish to come within reach. That's the kind of method I would count on.
Makes sense.
Calm and steady. Exactly the kind of person who would catch loads of fish.
Yep. And I can be their assistant.
With discretion, I'm sure.
I'd probably use some sort of mechanical animal. Papa once bought me some small clockwork squirrels, mice, and such. When placed in the forest, they can attract others of their kind. I remember that you liked those too, didn't you?
I did. And that would be a good way to go about it. If they're realistic enough, animals of the same kind will follow them all the way to the trap.
What about you, Monsieur Neuvillette?
I fear I do not have any related experience.
Fair enough.
That makes sense. You usually solve problems directly, without the use of any such tricks. But I do have one more question for you, Monsieur. If we were to create a trap now, how would you design it?
I would like for it to be effective, but bring no harm to the prey. A more gentle trap would be ideal.
Kind, as always. However, our intention doesn't necessarily change the containment device and the type of implement we need. If we wanted to kill the prey in one strike, we would need a powerful implement. However, that also goes for prey that must be captured and safely contained.
Wait, why is that?
Only a hunter who's a true expert at subduing their prey can snare it without harming it. The line that divides life and death is often exceedingly thin.
So, are we going hunting together?
Sort of.
We hadn't thought of seeing ourselves as hunters. It kinda works, but maybe it's still not the best metaphor.
If our means of capturing and dealing with our prey is to put them on trial, then the hunting metaphor is actually quite accurate. But we shall require much more courage than any hunter to judge a god, a being whose seat is an exalted throne.
Oh, so that's what's going on. Sounds very interesting.
Okay, so we're gonna go and try to catch Farina. This is gonna be fun. So, how are we gonna do this? That is the question. Here we go. We reached this place. So what now?
It's been a tough few days, hasn't it? So much has been happening. Hyman didn't think the meetings would go on for so long, but everyone seemed pretty fired up, huh?
It's gonna be the hunt of the year.
Well, Fremenay was, now that Hyman thinks about it, but everyone else just looked a little surprised.
Oh, eh? I suppose in a way.
Well, it's hard to say. Hyman doesn't have any experience with this sort of thing. But with you around, Hyman sure will do great. After all, you're the most reliable person in the world, aren't you?
what? You don't know I pretty much fixed at least, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 nations. I fixed their problems.
Did you just pour some tea? Hyman didn't notice you doing that at all.
What? I didn't.
Then what's that?
Hello.
Hyman's never seen that cup before.
Don't be frightened. I'm just joining you two for tea. I merely refrained from saying anything till now.
Oh.
Who's that voice?
Talking tea? It's a talking tea.
What a strange conclusion, but also such an interesting one. You two make such a fascinating combo.
Thank you.
Even you feel confused. As such, I couldn't resist but come by for some tea and a chat. Consider me a passerby, just accepting a commission from my friend's disciple on a whim.
Oh? Oh.
Precisely. Call me N, a mage who wanders the world. At least, that's how my friends have suggested that I introduce myself. The prophecy. Yes, what has been prophesized will be fulfilled. You may view such things as the history of the future.
What?
That's an interesting view.
Then is there any way we can stop it?
People call such things fate, and it is written in the stars. It cannot so easily be altered. Ah, so you've caught on. Just as prophecies are usually only the future as seen from the perspectives of the gods, could things be happening in hidden corners where the gods' gaze does not fall?
Oh.
Are the things that you shall see different from the fate that the gods perceive?
I get it.
What is she talking about? It all sounds really impressive and important and stuff, but it also sounds kind of scary.
I believe that you understand, right? Some things are insignificant, but others you must reach out to change. Ultimately, fate shall serve as your only guide. No matter what will happen in Teyvat's future, all you need to do is to play your part. This was good tea, by the way. Thank you for your hospitality. Well, that'll be all for today.
All right, I hope you enjoy it.
It's gone.
And the tea is also gone.
Someone talking.
All right, who is it?
All right, coming. Hey, it's you who's getting lazy, okay?
Shut up.
Wow, I see I've walked in on some lively banter.
Luna!
Fine. I went to take part in that Steambird panel. It turned out to be more interesting than I expected. Not all Fontanians are pessimistic about this. One journalist mentioned that sitting around and waiting for the inn to come would be wrong, and that they should make their own rescue preparations. I agreed, so we had a brief chat with her.
Charlotte,
isn't it? Why, yes, it was Charlotte. I assume you've heard of her, no? That daredevil journalist? I'm in full support of her view. Prophecies are very important, but how can people allow their lives to be commandeered by just a few words?
That's right! Paimon's glad to hear something sensible for once.
Ah, yes. About what we had discussed before. I did try, but I'm afraid I couldn't reach the old hag. I'll try again tonight, but I wouldn't get your hopes up. Huh?
Yeah, it was quite interesting, actually.
Are you serious?
She said that even the god's gaze has blind spots. Pretty bold, if you ask Paimon. Most people would believe the gods to be all-knowing, right?
That is true.
The circle members are certainly anything but ordinary. As for the mage named N, the old hag has mentioned her a few times. She said that N's sense of direction is incredible, and that she loves guiding those who are lost.
Oh, I see.
But I've never met her, and if she were still alive, she'd be... Well, suffice it to say that the hag's at least a few hundred now, and N's been around for longer than that.
Oh my.
Whoa. The Hexen Circle sounds like a scary group. But they must really stay in shape to live so long.
I guess
so. Their abilities alone are pretty terrifying. If she came to see you personally, then the problem you're facing must truly be of great importance.
Well, it's not like Paimon could understand anything she said.
But I did.
Yes, she was quite cryptic, but I suspect she means that there is still a way to turn things around. She didn't say when or what that would be, though, so
Perhaps it is something that you cannot know right now. Traveler, Paimon, are you two all right?
Just thinking.
Oh, we're fine. We're just a little down right now. It kind of feels like the end is coming, you know?
I see. I feel that same sense of desperation, too. I guess you could consider me someone who has often witnessed fate. So far as I have seen, it cannot be swayed. But even so, I still hope for and believe in miracles. Astrology is eternal and rational, but fate may not be. It is cruel, but it can also be beautiful. Perhaps that's what En was trying to tell you. Not to lose heart, and to believe that what you are seeing playing out before you is not yet set in stone. I did originally think of steering clear of all this, but I couldn't. Even if this is all futile, I still wish to help everyone. If we don't struggle to the last, then how can we face the end when it comes?
Huh. You do have a point.
Yep.
There I go, talking about astrological principles again. Sorry about that. The moment I start talking about work-related stuff... I need to get going. It was worth trying to comfort you, even if only a little. I believe that you'll help those who are struggling in the same way I did. I suppose that might be why we always seem to meet by coincidence.
I suppose. I definitely need your story.
Paimon feels kinda moved by what Mona said. But also kinda sad, too. Hey, Traveler. Paimon suddenly feels like going outside for a walk. Let's go.
Yeah, sure. But like I said, I probably gonna do those missions. Like in one of those special episodes. Like, you only focus on them. So, yeah. I'll definitely have to do more before anything else.
Let's walk around the city, shall we? There's a few spots we always like to walk by.
Let me just confirm. Yeah, right. Here we have the, yeah, this is the one I need to do. But let's see, this is a, oh yeah, this is story quests. I'm gonna do some special episodes. They're gonna be like story quests, which is every single one of them. Most likely I should probably start with Mona because of her appearing right now.
Make mistakes. It's all part of the learning process.
Yeah, whatever you say. But yeah, I am definitely gonna have to do that. I'll probably record it before, as soon as I can. Hopefully I can finish these story quests as soon as I can. I mean the main story, the Archon story, and then I shall focus on the story quests.
Huh? Our names are written in this newspaper. What's going on?
Paimon, have you been paying attention to anything?
Let Paimon see!
Alright then.
The underwater stronghold, the Fortress of Meripede, has continued in its noble autonomy, but that does not mean that others cannot interact with it. My recent attempts to enter the fortress bore little fruit. Huh. Guess Charlotte still hasn't given up on that.
Oh my.
Thus, did an Outlander friend become the focus of this report? A blind adventurer with their white fairy legends trailing in their wake.
White fairy.
It is said that this mysterious traveler once visited the underwater fortress. So while the fortress's interior remains a mystery behind closed doors, do not fear, for the tales of the traveler contain surprises in space. Journalist Charlotte's biggest scoop yet, the Traveler's Trail, World Walker. Huh. Charlotte took so many awesome photos of us and we never even noticed her.
She really is a professional,
she
I guess.
She hasn't been able to get a hold of anything at the fortress, so since we're easier to find, she's using us as the subject matter instead? Ugh, seriously? Well, fine. Those headlines and photos do look cool, so Paimon will forgive her this time.
Damn it, I want to see the photos. Let me see. Oh no, it's so awkward.
We're here! Paimon's hungry. Should we go in and get something to eat?
You're always thinking about food. Didn't you just ate a few minutes ago?
That's the limited edition, only 16 slices a day cake! It was so delicious the last time we tried it! Despite the tense situation we were in, let's give it...
Yes, let's go.
One slice of cake, please.
Someone showed up after all! Oh,
that's
wait, you're the one from the Palais Mermonia!
Oh,
are you here to buy cake too? It seems Monsieur Nervalette was right. You really can eat.
It's all Palmy's fault.
Like that.
It is.
That's right. Even he has his own preferences when it comes to food. As for me, I love the cake and coffee here.
Do Ooh. You come here often?
Usually every day.
Every day?
It's part of my daily schedule, apart from work. I shall have my cake and coffee.
Are you okay?
Then what if someone told you one day that this place would be closing soon, and you wouldn't get to eat cake here anymore?
Paimon?
What would you think?
But why would it close?
Well, Paimon doesn't know either, but maybe... Maybe the waters will rise tomorrow. You know, like in the prophecy.
Oh, the prophecy. To be honest, I haven't paid much attention to that. No, still, even if there'd be no more cake tomorrow, that wouldn't keep me from having some today. No, it's the same for eating in general. You might not be able to eat tomorrow, but if you can do so today, then you should carry on. That's what people call living, you know.
Fair enough.
Don't be sad. Excuse me, could I have two more slices of cake to go?
Oh?
These two slices are for you. Sichuan said that this kind of expression you're making is what humans call being sad.
Oh, you know Sichuan?
Yes, he does.
I sure do. She was born before me, and she sometimes comes to the surface to teach us things about humans.
Wow, that's something.
That humans are creatures that are saddened easily. Yes, and you can only lift their spirits by feeding them delicious food. So please try the cakes here. I've got something else to do, so I'll be going now. You two try to stay in a good mood after eating, all right? Bye.
Well, thank you. Well, that's
there she
nice.
Goes. All right, let's dig in. I'm sure this cake will be delicious.
I guess we're eating cake.
It's more delicious than last time! And the flavor gets even better with a sip of tea! It sure would be nice if we could come again tomorrow! Sure would be nice if we could always eat delicious food here.
Oh, Paimon, she's... Looks like Paimon's going through a mood. Aww. I feel sorry for her. At the same time, I start to get a bit hungry. I should probably finish my drink.
We're near the Seabird office! Let's go look for Charlotte and have a chat!
Okay. What? Sorry, what? Oh my god. Well, this is awkward. Okay. Now I was planning to go into the mission that I need to do in order to continue the main quest. However, guys, I will show you guys something. Ladies and gentlemen, I got her. After so long, I finally fucking got her. Let me see, can find her. Where the fuck are you? Okay, there you are. Raiden Shogun, I finally did it. Oh my god. Okay. Now I just need then try to get my hands on her. And I pretty much have every single one of these two banners. Oh boy. Now then, allow me to continue the. Oh boy, it's another one of those times. Oh fuck, the game is lagging so much. But yeah, I'm gonna do the this quest. I'm gonna try to do it as fast as I can. And then I'll head out towards the main quest. So yeah, give me a few minutes, I guess. They only unlock this. Fuck! Oh damn it. Sometimes certain words. Repeat. Fuck! Oh, I hate it when I fail saying certain words, but I guess this is all I needed, right? Okay, it is.
A good newspaper should be.
That's all I needed to do. So I guess I can continue with the main quest. Perfect. Here we go. I just hope that if there's any cutscenes, there won't be any.
Have you seen the article?
Any problems?
You've got some nerve. You just used death to make some quick mora.
Oh, you needn't worry about that. I heard that you were in Poissons some time back, so I sent you a letter to discuss just that. It appears you didn't receive it, though.
Yeah, right, I mean, there's a lot of shit going
on here. The attended for you. I've even set the table with some food.
I would have more. Paimon. God damn it, Paimon.
You're almost a little too easy to win over, Paimon.
Get win
win. If I were a journalist with ulterior motives, you'd be in trouble now, you know.
Oh my god, Charlotte. She even admits it.
You're not like that.
Paimon.
Still, what brings you here all of a sudden? Were you looking for me?
Well, I guess I am.
A friend of ours met you a while back, and when she mentioned it, we thought of coming to see you. Her name's Mona.
Oh yeah, that. That's what we
want. Ah, so you know Miss Mona as well. She's a guest columnist for our paper. A really good one, too. She's so young and already such a brilliant astrologist.
God damn it. Honestly, I really don't like this. The game
so, she mentioned me? What did she say?
She said that you're a real daredevil of a journalist.
Nice. In which case,
oh my God.
This daredevil
nice.
Journalist dare to request an exclusive interview with the legendary Traveler and Paimon?
Oh, huh? Yeah.
So your article in the paper today doesn't count?
Oh, of course it doesn't. That was more like live photography. What I'd like to do is dive deeper and ask you to talk about the things you've seen and experienced.
Yeah, are we even qualified enough?
Paimon. Do we really have to go through with this?
Why not? If I say you're worth an interview, then you're worth it. But not right now, of course. I'll need a few days to prepare.
Oh, in that case, we'll just chat when you have the time then?
Oh, so that's a yes? Ooh, splendid! I'll tell the editor-in-chief immediately. I'll have to apply for lighting, a venue, some props, and...
Oh dear.
Ooh, so much to get done now. Talk to you later.
Charlotte, Paimon's still got a question for you.
And she's off.
Hmm? And
oh, she heard that.
If, just for example, Fontaine were to be flooded tomorrow, what would you do today?
My god, Paimon's really...
That's the prophecy you're talking about, isn't it? I mean, I do hear about it often, but I've never once thought that the day could be tomorrow. If you're seriously asking, then I might try and think of a way to leave Fontaine. Oh, but I'm still a journalist, first and foremost. That means I have a duty to be reporting from the scene. And secondly, I wouldn't forsake my homeland that easily. From what I've seen, most people don't know what they'd do should the worst come to pass.
That's usually how
it happens.
In truth,
it might be better just to behave like normal rather than worry over such an end.
God damn it. I really apologize, everyone, for these amazing lags. But honestly, I really have no idea what's going on.
I'd probably still be prepping at the office
for that interview. Sometimes it's just fine, the other time it's just
I know what you're thinking.
Like this.
That sounds a bit sad, but I've always believed that it's best to do what you enjoy. Just think about it. If this nation really were to be suddenly destroyed tomorrow, but I still successfully finish an exclusive interview with a truly unique person.
You're talking about me,
aren't you? The story I would wind up writing would truly be timeless. And then do you know what I'd do? Well, I'd write that story, send it for printing, and use messenger pigeons to get copies out to the various nations as soon as possible. I'm not a dreamer, nor am I a workaholic, but I do love my job, and I'd be proud of leaving such an article behind. I guess you could say that I was born to be a journalist. But anyway, that's my answer. And on that note, I'll get back to my preparations.
That's so nice. All of a sudden, Paimon actually kind of envies her.
I mean, nobody knows
anyway,
what they do.
Anyway, let's go and take a look at the sea, shall we?
During an emergency moment. I mean, like a disaster moment, you know? And there's a lot of types of reaction. Sometimes people freak out, other people are actually able to stay calm, others try to escape, others try to save others. There's also sometimes people decide all of a sudden become the leader, you know, coordinate the rescue mission, everything. There's a lot of reactions. So technically speaking, you never know when what might happen. Yeah. Now I just remember something. There was this one time that my nephew fell and hit his mouth. It was bleeding so much. At first I didn't see it. I was in another room. It was my father that saw it. And when I saw my nephew just bleeding out of his mouth, I froze. I heard a lot of people get that reaction. It's kind of bad if you want to help. Then again, what can I even do? Don't worry, of course it got better. But still.
The sea breeze and scenery can be a pretty soothing combo, huh?
It is beautiful. Aw, Paimon.
Paimon's been thinking. If it wasn't Fontaine, but all of Teyvat that would be destroyed tomorrow, where would we go and what would we do? No, Paimon should ask, if you could choose, what would you like to do?
I wonder if that's some kind of hint for the future. I mean, from what I heard, Kadri got destroyed. The whole nation. I mean, it wasn't the whole world, but still. I wonder.
We've always been moving to the next destination, so we haven't spent much time thinking about these kinds of things. We didn't have to either, with us always being on the road and whatnot. You mean, still traveling? Huh. Wait, isn't that what we've always been doing?
Exactly. Oh god damn it! Oh my god.